Hi Nicole, this is Rebecca with your Assignment 1 critique. Great job completely changing the context of these original images. This first image is really well retouched. I mean, the original image of the guys in the car was, there wasn't a lot to work with there. So you did a good job bringing some deep dark blacks out of there and some bright white highlights so it looks more contrasty. And all the retouching that you did over on this guy over here, I mean, that's a lot of work, so I totally understand that. And it was a really fun image to choose, so I'm glad that you did. The only things I see that are some areas for improvement is by getting rid of these guys over on this side, the car kind of disappears, and it's kind of strange because then you don't really know what this is until you look down here and you see, oh, it's the front of a car. Like, so what is it? You know, it's a little bit confusing. So I would have recommend kind of keeping these guys in and getting rid of maybe the two little heads of these guys that were popping over the top, but keeping all the other guys in, and so that at least like the car could continue into the perspective of the background. And, you know, if you wanted to get, yeah, anyway, I was going to say if you want to get more landscape in there, you could flip it to have it be a landscape orientation, but then I realized that the original image of the guys is cropped there, so that wouldn't work. So forget that idea. But what you could do, since there would be more dudes in the picture, is just raise the background a little bit higher and then clone in whatever was missing down in here. Like, it looks like you may have kind of done that. I'm not sure. But the other thing that I really liked from your description is that you liked the image because it had the idea of saying, hey, mom, we're okay kind of thing. And I think I would have liked to see, instead of greetings from the boys, I would have liked to see, hey, mom, we're okay, Big Sur, California, because it's even more personal and funny and, you know, appropriate for their age and whatever the weird stuff they were doing, maybe their first time away from home or their first year of college or whatever, you know. So don't be afraid to, like, go with your gut on stuff like that. But other than that, you know, this was a really great integration. The background looks like it could really be there, and you did a great job restoring that old photo. On the second image, I love the contrast of the background image and the Chicago record cover. And that's some really good black and white conversion there. There is it's really contrasty, and so what that does with these two figures in the foreground being more grayed out is it makes them just look super gray, and your eye just keeps getting pulled to the background, and the background isn't necessarily the subject. You know, this is about this cute couple that you're trying to create. So I recommend pulling more contrast out of the cute couple. That image of Eleanor was really a hard one too. I don't know if you could have picked a harder image to work with, honestly. Like, it was so flat and gray with not very much detail. So I'm impressed that you got as much out of her as you did. The only thing is we need to see some whiter whites, and there's a few areas where that we can have that opportunity in her teeth and in the highlight of her glasses, maybe down here in these rings. So using the levels adjustment layer, you just pull the white slider over to the left a little bit, and you'll see those whites start coming out. I don't know if you'll have to adjust the black slider at all, if there's any kind of compensation that you'll need to do, because it's already really black. Like, this dress is very dark, and so I'm not sure. If you notice that your shadow in her hair here and in the behind her neck and in her eyes here, if that starts getting too gray when you start pulling that white slider over, because sometimes that happens, then yeah, go ahead and pull the black one over to compensate a little bit. I don't recommend really messing with the gray middle slider when you're doing this. Just work with the black and white on the outsides of the levels adjustment layer. So your grandpa needs some work. He got distorted in the process. So whenever you're using the transform tool to try to change the scale of an object, make sure that you hold down the shift button when you have, once you have the transform box around it, hold down the shift button before you start grabbing any areas with your mouse, and then only grab a corner of the transformation box. Don't grab the top line or the side line. Here we grabbed the side line and squished him over this way, and now he's tall and skinny, and you know his head's elongated. So we want to try to keep the original proportions and not have any distortion. So hold down the shift button, click on the corner box with your mouse, and pull in or pull out to change the scale of your object. And then make sure you let go of your mouse button before you let go of the shift button. The other thing is he definitely has some areas that the white could be whiter. So his shirt and his cuff right here. And there's even a little highlight in his glasses, and his teeth might get a little whiter. I'm looking at the image, the original image. His teeth are a little bit in shadow, so they might not be perfectly gleaming white, but the shirt will be. So using the same levels adjustment layer, pull that white slider over to the left, get those whites whiter, and then pull the black slider over to the right and get those blacks darker and richer, like how dark her shirt is over on this side. And then it'll totally balance with what's going on back here in the background, and the whole image will feel more three-dimensional. So I would, if you still have a cutout of him by himself, I would bring like the original cutout over, because it might be hard to try to change the dimensions of him, like to undistort him. But you may be able to figure it out just by eyeballing the original image. So anyway, other than that, these concepts were fantastic. I really love the way your brain's working on those, and I want to see more of that. I can't wait to see what you bring to the next assignment. Keep up the great work.